Hello everybody, so through this session in grammar we will continue with our previous topic of non-finite verbs. We have discussed that non-finite verbs are further of three kinds, the infinitive, the gerund, the participle, whereas the infinitives are further divided into infinitive, 2 plus first form, and bare infinitive means only first form of the verb, and further the gerund is verb plus ing. So in today's section we will discuss the participle. So participles are further divided into present participle, past participle and perfect participle. So these are further, present participle, this is first form plus ing, and this is quite confusing because our gerund is also like that. Second, past participle, it is only third form of the verb, and perfect participle is having plus third form of the verb. Now as you saw that gerund is also verb plus ing, and present participle is also first form plus ing, it is same, both are same. So what are the differences between participle and gerund that we will see right now? First of all, as we have already discussed, that gerund is used as a noun form, if you remember, and our participle, this is used as adjective. So this is the difference between gerund and participle, that the participle is used as the adjective, whereas gerund is used as noun. So wherever you need it, you need a noun form, you should use first form plus ing as a gerund, and where you need adjective you will use first form plus ing as a participle. Now we will try to understand with the help of some examples. Now I am giving two sentences to you. First is, he jumped off a dash train. And second is, dash is a good exercise. Now you see here, he jumped off a train. Sentence is complete. Here we need talking about adjective to qualify the train. We can write down, he jumped off a running train. And on the other hand, we can write down here also, running is a good exercise. Now see, at both the places we have used verb run plus ing, running. Now talking about, in the first case it is qualifying the train, so it's a adjective, but here it is noun form, that's why this is gerund. Now that only is the difference between participle and gerund, that where we need adjective we will use first form plus ing as a participle, and wherever we need talking about noun form, there we will use first form plus ing as a gerund. Further, we will take some examples like, he came dash like a frog
.
the dash horse could not run. Here is the dash window. Next, the sun dash nothing could be seen. This is our dash room. There is no dash water. And hawk is a dash bird. He threw the dash papers. So starting with the first sentence, it was he came dash like a frog. He came jumping like a frog. Second, the dash horse could not run. Injured horse could not run. Now, should not forget, injured is the third form. Here is the, again, third form. Here is the broken window. Again, third form. Fourth sentence, the sun having set. Now, this is our third kind of past participle, having plus third form of the verb. And after that, the sun having set, nothing could be seen. Fifth is, this is our dash room. This is our dining room. This is our reading room. Whatever. There is no dash water. There is no drinking water. Hawk is a, which kind of bird is hawk? Just tell me first. Hawk is a hunting bird. And last sentence, he threw the dash papers. He threw the burnt papers. Now talking about, just try to see everybody. Here, the verb is not jumping, but came. Jumping is talking about just how he came. So it is qualifying the verb. So that's why it is not the verb. It is here the non-finite verb. In the same way, the injured horse could not run. The verb is definitely run. Injured is the third form and it's adjective and it is qualifying horse. And that's why non-finite verb participle. Further, Here is the broken window. Broken is just qualifying window. It is the third form of break, but the verb is. The sun having set, talking about nothing could be seen. Now this is the verb. It has already been done. This is the activity. And that's why, again, non-finite verb. Further, this is the verb, reading, read plus ing. This is qualifying our room. This is adjective here. And sixth sentence, there is no drinking. The same way, verb is. And drinking, talking about, same way, drinking is drink plus ing. It is not qualifying water. It is used as adjective, and it is the main verb. Further, we are having hawk. It is not telling the quality of the bird. Verb is here. And third and the last sentence, burnt, third form of burn, telling the quality of papers, used as adjective. The main verb is through. Now why I have defined these verbs, main verbs, and these one, just to tell you people that the main verbs are called finite verbs, whereas are non-finite verbs are these, which are beyond any boundary of person, number, and tense. These are non-finites, and other verbs are called finite verbs. So with this, our topic ends here. Thank you.